Okay, guys, we had to refill the stove once. It came up almost done, but then we had to run out of fuel. So I let it cool, fired it back up, and now we have come back to a good rolling boil. I've let it boil about 5 minutes. Secret to pasta is don't overcook it. These big open L's make great camp knives for kitchen knives and things, and that backside is perfect for a flint striker. So it's one of my favorite camp cooking knives. Now, snag me a couple of noodles. Let's give her a taste. Perfect. Got my pot off. Let it rest just a second. Pathfinder stove cool a minute. Took about 1.5 fillings to cook spaghetti in that pot with a 3/4 filling of water. So it's like 1.5, 1 3/4 quarts water. There, snuff it out. I like to take my O-ring out, snuff it out, make sure it ain't got hot, and now I put my O-ring back in. That way I don't lose my O-ring. And now I let it cool. Now my sauce I generated earlier is still hot to the touch. Double bag. So what I want to do is put that where I'm not going to step on it. Let it naturally cool off. Put the lid on. And utilizing that pour spout, I'm going to eliminate the excess water. Again, kudos to the designer of the pot. The handle is cool. That rebated lid that locks in, big asset. You saw in the bread baking video how I was able to put hot coals and stuff on top of it without putting ash into the pot. Well, this lock-in lid, now that I can easily just hold it with my fingers in a rag, allow me to drain without having to worry about the lid popping off sideways. Okay. Now, we could put the sauce directly in the pot, but that's going to dirty the pot. We're going to go the other way. We're going to put the spaghetti and all into the sauce. That's the reason I did it in this bag. Nice and easy. When you're cooking, a lot of times it's what you think about. How you think about your next move's going to be and what it's going to entail. And like I said, I could easily just dump the sauce in. That would dirty up the pot worse. Now, as you can see, that pot is not that bad. Now go ahead and put some water to it. Give it a quick rinse out. Get all that excess out of there. Relatively clean pot. Now, of course, I'm gonna put soap in this and clean it a little later on. Just not right now, not on camera. Not gonna waste your time with that. That stainless steel's cool enough to touch. That's cool enough now. Zip up our spaghetti, put it into the inner bag, zip that bag up, and mix sauce and spaghetti. Now by doing it this way, my sauce is nice and thick. my spaghetti is nice and thick. And I've got all that meat in it, all at one time. Now making sure the outer bag is clean. Open it up. Fold open. And voila. Spaghetti. Hot spaghetti too. Perfect, just enough meat, just enough sauce. Got big chunks of meat in it. Oh yeah, this is gonna be a good meal. And all of it cooked in one pot with the use of a bag and a little bitty stove. And like I said, sorry for the helicopter guys. I'm doing a stealth sneak through here today, doing a little scout on a wetland area that I've been doing some nature photography on. So I want to go in and out real quietly. By doing this, when I get done, I'm going to kick the pine straw back over this. There won't be any embers from a fire or anything like that. You'll never know I was here. That's the secret to stealth camping. No noise in, no noise out. Never knew I was there. That's great. Okay, guys, I hope you've enjoyed this. Next, we're going to do a dessert. We're going to make an old southern recipe that's been done for God knows how long, called dump or cobbler, depending on how you make it. I'm Blackie for Shaman's Forge Bushcraft, wishing you safe journeys. Have a great day, guys.